On May Day, 1969, the Black Panther Party held rallies across the nation, demanding that jailed Minister of Defense Huey P. Newton be set free. On the original May Day in 1886, Polish, German, Irish, and Italian working people held the first massive strike in America. Organized in Chicago to gain an 8-hour workday, it spread to all the major industrial cities, and on May 1st was supported by hundreds and thousands of working men and women. But the millionaire rulers of America were determined to crush the people. Armies of city cops and hired goons shot them down in the streets, and the strike leaders were arrested, tried, and hanged. The Black Panther Party today is carrying on the same fight for all working people, white and black, and for this they have been slandered in the press, murdered in cold blood, and framed and jailed by a ruling class jealous of its power.
Is a danger to the community. What do you say?
Right on. People have been working to free Huey ever since Huey P. Newton first was shot in October of 1967, just as hard as Huey P. Newton was working to free black people in 66 when he started the Black Panther Party.
Now, I know you heard a lot lately about what big mafioso Mussolini Alioto has had to say, like he wants to destroy the Black Panther Party.
A lot of propaganda going on for today. And the Panthers, they were making an extra hard job to go and mobilize the people for this rally. The pigs, they sought to stop this. Got on the loudspeaker, and this is what he said. Everyone in the Panther office, come out with your hands up and leave your guns. We don't take orders from pigs, so we didn't do this. By the time we got out the back entrance, there was about four pigs waiting for us at the gate. The tear gas affected us so bad that one of the sisters, she couldn't see where she was going and she was falling. So the field marshal grabbed her and he was holding her up. The pig said, "God damn it, nigga, I told you to get your hands up against the motherfucking wall." So the field marshal said, I'm trying to hold his sister up. She's about to faint. When he said this, I don't know the pig's real name, but the Panthers call him Big Red. Big Red turned around and leveled his M16 at Don Cox's head and fired about 5 rounds from a fully automatic weapon. The bullets went through his hair and bounced off the wall. He tried to kill the field marshal of the Black Panther Party, Don Cox. At this time, there was about 2,000 people on the scene, and the pigs started firing their Thompson machine guns and their M16s over the people's heads. And then pigs were grabbing our sisters and throwing them down and just generally running them up.
Of fascism in our land.
Well, the Black Panther Party and black people and Mexican-American people and all people are saying there will always be Huey P. Newton and the Black Panther Party as long as there's black people living in existence.
Right on!
Free Huey! Show this United States government this red book. Is this the answer? They said it. You hear them? Do you hear them in there? They're talking about the red book by Channing Mao of Red China. That's what they got in their hands. The people are tired of the bullshit. And I'm tired of all that theory that's written down on paper. It ain't being put on practice. And they got this red book.
In the papers this morning, they're saying that the Black Panther Party is subversive. Well, this is all the Black Panther Party has to say to all those pigs in the power structure. The Black Panther Party, along with other members of the community, are feeding 2,000 young brothers and sisters every morning. If that's subversive, then damn it, we subversive.
As you know, we have initiated a free breakfast for school children. The reason behind this is because we understand that our children go hungry. Because we understand that the pigs won't get up off their ass and give us no food. Because we understand that there's a oppressor. The Black Panther Party says that we're going to serve these children. We're going to feed them every morning. They get a full meal, grits, bacon, toast, eggs, everything they need for the whole day. We need the people's support. We need your actions. We need your money. We need your donations. We need your time. The breakfast program is a program for the people and by the people. All the Black Panther Party has done was taking the basic needs of the people and putting them into practice because we are practitioners.
We're saying that if it had not been for Huey P. Newton, there would not have been any breakfast for children. If it had not been for Huey P. Newton, community control of police would not be in the process of being implemented by the people. If it had not been for Huey P. Newton, free health clinics would not be in the process of being implemented in the black community. If it had not been for Huey P. Newton, the 10-point platform and program of the Black Panther Party would not begin to be implemented by the people, and not only black people, because the Chinese Americans, the Red Guard, has copied the same 10-point platform and program, and they got a right to it. an Indian American organization, NARP, named NARP, has copied the same 10-point platform and program of the Black Panther Party, and they got a right to it. We're just waiting for this racism to break down when we see the poor white Appalachians up in the mountains copy the same 10-point platform and program and go forth to destroy the Nixons, the Reagans, and the Pig Aliotos.
Right on, Bobby. Right on, Bobby. And let me say one thing to the white people in the audience. Now, you know, Bobby has been saying for a long time, we will not fight racism with racism. We refuse to stoop to the level of a racist to hate somebody because of the color of his skin. Well, that's fine. But I see a lot of white people walking around and say, oh, good. Now the Black Panther Party don't hate me. I can go on about my business. That's a cop-out, brothers. And if you act like that, the Black Panther Party will hate you. Not because you're white, but because you ain't taking care of business to organize other people. Teach them the need to support the Black Liberation Movement led by the Black Panther Party as a strong, fearless voice against American imperialism, and to link up with all the people in Vietnam, in China, in Cuba, in Angola, in Latin America, and everywhere else who are standing shoulder to shoulder to drive this vicious beast out of the way and out of the pages of history.
When the party says power to the people, we ain't jiving a pound. We say power to the people. And when the people say to Reagan, when the people say to Alioto, when the people say to Pig Richard M. Nixon that we want Huey P. Newton free, we're saying you bald-headed pig punks better get out of the way because we're tired. That we're saying you better let Huey go.
Huey wants to be out here so he can provide the leadership to the people's revolution, so he can take this country and change it, turn it upside down and put the last first and the first last, not only for black people, but for all people. So everybody knows that all the people don't have liberties, all the people don't have freedom, all the people don't have justice, and all the people don't have power, so that means none of us do.
The only way we're going to get some freedom and the only way we're going to get Huey P. Newton free is to understand where we, the people, are. I want you to repeat after me. I am a revolutionary.
A revolutionary.
They have never lacked the Black Panther Party standing up and saying we're revolutionaries and practicing revolutionary action. They have never lacked the Black Panther Party standing up and proving through social practice that we're not racist, but proving that they, in fact, are the real racists. They have never lacked the Black Panther Party saying that we want some socialistic programs implemented in the black community so we can survive and be free. They have never lacked the Black Panther Party and the people talking about we want some community control of police. They have never lacked the 10-point platform and program of the Black Panther Party. They have never respected Huey P. Newton, but we respect Huey P. Newton. We love Huey P. Newton.
Right on.
We love all our people.
We love all our people.
We love our people so much that if the pigs attack us, we're going to defend ourselves rightfully with guns and force. And that's our message to Pig Alioto and Richard M. Nixon's America. Thank you, and free Huey!
Free!